To the show. This is the first episode of my new talk show, which is called Vernon Howl's Drive Time. And basically what it is, I have an iPhone 4. It's not the 4S. It's the old 4. I like Apple, and I've had it for 2 years. I can record my voice on it. And in the afternoons, most afternoons, what I'll do is it's a talk show, because I'm talking, not so much a podcast, in that it's not following the traditional podcast form. You can call it a podcast if you want to think of it that way. It's something you can download and listen to anywhere you want, really. I think I'll probably put it as an MP3 somewhere, or I might even put it on a YouTube video. So all of these things are now really nice things, because you can listen to them anywhere, and even a YouTube video, if you want to just pull out, if you get a link on your phone, like if you were wanted to also listen to this in your car, because I'm taping this right now from the car. If you hear a little bit of the outside noises or any kind of background noise, that's because this is a live from a car talk show, Vernon Howl's Drive Time. Most afternoons, and I tape it at the best time of the day, when you get off at, when the whistle blows and you're done for the day and you're driving home. But anyway, like I was saying before, what it'll probably be is a YouTube video. So I'll sync the audio up with probably a picture of something that I took today. So I'll get a nice picture of maybe a bird. I actually put that on my to-do list today. Take a picture of a bird. I have not seen a bird yet today. So I have to still take a picture of a bird. Anyway, so we could put that on there. If I can't find a picture of a bird, I'm sure I can take another picture. Or just go to googleimage.com and find a nice picture, I will edit the sound file that I'm making now and put it with the image. So when you log on to youtube.com, and then, well, you'll probably get a link from my website, which is vernonhowl.com. You can get back to the where I'm having the site hosted, or it'll probably be in a blog post anyway. There, but let's say, so we'll take it back to before I got off on this tangent. What I was talking about is, let's say you wanted to listen to this while you were driving, and you're saying, oh, well, it's a YouTube video, not quite an MP3, like I don't have my iPod hooked up to my car, or I could have, you know, maybe you don't even have a car jack for that. You know, some cars just have the CD now, so if you're like not that new, that they didn't quite have the hookup for having an iPod. Some cars don't have that. They just have CD players, which is kind of, there's not much you can do there, what you do there, in this case, bring your phone on your phone, or if you even have an iPad would also work well. So you sync it up before you leave the house, or before you leave the store, or before you leave your office, and you have it ready to go. So you have the iPad maybe propped up in the window, like in the dashboard. Maybe it's sitting on the dashboard. If you have maybe a Velcro, you could Velcro your phone to there. And before you leave, just make sure that you have this file of the show, Vernon Howl's Drive Time, this is episode 1, synced up on the dashboard. And so you can just have that ready to go. And then you know, make sure you're on like a good 3G network. Press play on the YouTube video. There's nothing to watch. It's just going to be one photo, so you're not missing anything by just, you know, using your old listening ears. Don't have to worry about missing out on any kind of video I'm taking, because you know, I've had a couple of false starts in my life, especially in the online show hosting, video show. I've tried numerous versions of shows, and I do have a podcast, which is a different format than what we're doing here, than this talk show. My podcast is more of a traditional podcast, which is like I'm being a DJ and I'm playing my favorite records. But that's also available on VernonHowl.com. That's called an unpolished podcast for small mammals, different than this show, which is Vernon Howl's Drive Time Episode 1. And this is the intro, first episode. What is it exactly? What are you listening to? It's a great question. I leave work in the afternoon. I put my phone in a little holder underneath my... I have a cassette player in my... I drive a 2001 Honda Accord. So I actually have capabilities to listen to my iPhone via the car speakers via a cassette to iPhone hookup, which is really a wonderful that I can still make use of that in this day and age. I guess this car's 11 years old. So the show is about really, you know, when you think of most talk shows, I think what you think of is, well, you got to have a good engaging host. And if you like the host, I think you're going to like the talk show. So if you generally like my website and you like what I do there, and you're thinking, well, you know, maybe... I'll give him a shot and I'll maybe listen to his daily show. Maybe it's pretty good. I hope you do, and I'd love to have you as a listener. I'm lucky enough that my commute isn't too long. Not to say I wouldn't like to talk to you longer, but that's just how it works out sometimes in life. You're going to get to pick and choose sometimes what your commutes are or what job you have or what you're going to eat for breakfast. That stuff sometimes is predetermined by other factors. That's all fine and good. You know, I'm going to put my seatbelt on here as the traffic let up a little bit. But like I was saying, I don't have much more than a 10-minute commute on most days. Sometimes a little longer if we got a little traffic. Today's a beautiful day. It's Friday, May 18th, 2012, and this is New Jersey. I live in part of New Jersey, a beautiful, beautiful part of New Jersey. Reservations tonight at a seafood restaurant. Me and the wife are going out and having a little seafood. I usually get like a tilapia or something like that. I usually don't spring for the lobster. Not so much because I'm cheap, but because I just don't really like lobster. Some people do. I'm not a huge shellfish guy in general. I don't like clams at all. I will eat lobster sometimes, but clams, no way. Not going to eat clams. Tried them. Not my thing. It's not even a taste thing. It's more of a texture issue. They feel very slimy in my mouth. So that is my plan tonight. I might have a martini. I'm a fan of the dirty martini these days. So yeah, pretty good. It's my first, like I said, it's a Friday, and this is my first week back from work after a lengthy vacation. And that's always rough when you get back to work. You're like, oh, back to the grind. But, you know, that's why I think this show is going to be a good thing. Just because it's, you know, just drive time. It's like, just, hey, whistle blew, day's out. Just get back to basics and just, you know, get back to what is really important in life, which is letting loose and having fun. So when I talk about eating seafood and drinking a martini, that's just my way of, letting myself relax and just, you know, expressing myself and what I like. I like the finer things. You get to a point in life, and I'm 31 years old, and you just gotta think to yourself, hey, you know, life is short. Yeah, sometimes you gotta go to work, but then also sometimes you get off of work, and then you're in your car, driving home, and that's really what America's all about. I had a idea for a song. It was called Fluoride Warlock in Heat. I just wanted to mention that on the show in case I forgot about it. I always have that on a record. I think about song titles a lot, and ideas for poems too. I'm a poet, and in addition to wearing other hats as one of them, talk show host. So yeah, we're almost home. And I'm really excited about this new show. I hope, you know, I'm not going to put it to my feet on the fire and say, hey, or, you know, I'm going to do this one a day. But it'd be nice to try and do that on the weekdays coming home from work, just as a way to be like, hey, time to get going for the weekend. But on a Tuesday night, there's no reason why on a Tuesday night you shouldn't get off work and let all your problems of work and in life and all your other issues behind you and just say, hey, getting back at it today. And I'm going to go photograph a bird, going to go write a song, going to go eat seafood, going to go have a martini, going to go drink wine, going to go play basketball, whatever is your, pick your poison, really. It could be any number of things, you know. You really, like I said before, life's too short. If you like detailing cars, if you like creating custom graphics for the sides of vans, that might be something you could do also as a job. I'm sure people get pay people to do that as well, but some people could do that in their free time. And really, there's no harm in it. So, I just want to have a good time. Like, I just think that the best thing in life is entertainment and keeping yourself entertained and, you know, not worrying so much what people think about you and just doing the things that make you happy. And, you know, maybe in my case, it's making a talk show on your way home from work. And maybe it's writing a song, like a love song or a poem. Writing a poem for someone that you know, or someone even that you don't know, someone that you met, you know. So that's really the format of this show. Maybe I'll talk about what I'm working on for the day, or, you know, maybe something that talk about things that happened to me, or what I'm doing for the night. Like I told you tonight, I'm going to a seafood restaurant, and I'm probably going to watch a little NBA playoffs. Both nice, really nice things. So, okay, well, I'm pulling in my driveway, and I guess that's the end of episode one of Drive Time, Vernon Howl's Drive Time. So thanks for listening, and I'll see you on the next one.